Lupin Pharmaceuticals in association with Higher Secondary Principals Forum.
Welcome back, students. Now today let us see one full problem on retirement of a partner. But before that, let me revise with you whatever we have done so far. So you have learned the various adjustments, the common adjustments which are necessary for retirement. We have already discussed and we have seen examples, journal entries which are required for making such adjustments. And also you have learned some calculations. So let us see what we have done so far. So we have seen first calculation of gain ratio or new profit sharing ratio. All of you have learned the various situations under which the gaining ratio or new profit ratio sharing ratio is to be calculated. Okay. So and same we have to apply when we are solving the problem on retirement of a partner. Treatment of goodwill also you have seen. Now when goodwill is adjusted, it is adjusted only to the extent of retiring partner's share. So what we do is we debit the remaining partner's capital accounts and we credit retiring partner's capital account, and because we have to give his share to him. And this is sharing is done in the gain ratio. So that you have learned, we have seen examples and also journal entries and how it will appear in the ledger accounts. Then you have also seen about accumulated profits and losses. Now accumulated profits and losses or undistributed profits and losses are to be distributed before the retirement, because retiring partner's share is to be credited to his capital account. So we have also seen that adjustment. Then revaluation of assets and liabilities, which you have learned in admission in details. So same thing you will be having here in retirement of a partner. I have only shown you how the profit or loss on revaluation is distributed among the partners. It is distributed to all partners before the retirement in their old profit sharing ratio. Calculation of total amount due to a retiring partner and settlement of his capital account. So you have seen what is the amount due. We have seen the various amounts or items which are credited to retiring partner's capital account, that is the amount due to him, total amount. And we have also seen the amount which is receivable, amount due from him, which is debited to his capital account. And the difference is actually the net amount which is payable to a retiring partner. So that is how we ascertain, and I have also shown you the slide on the same. And then whatever amount due to a retiring partner, there is a settlement to be done, meaning either you can transfer that balance of amount due to a retiring partner to his loan account, or you may immediately make the payment in lump sum, or part payment may be done and partly the balance may be transferred to his loan account. Besides this, we have some more adjustments, that is capital adjustments between the remaining partners. So that I have not explained you. First we shall see solve one problem including the adjustments which are shown in this slide up to 0.5. Okay, and besides there are two more adjustments which you have to learn, and that I'll be dealing with later on after solving the problem. So one is adjustment of capital's accounts of partners, and next is settlement of retiring partner's loan account. Okay, so now let us see full problem on retirement of a partner. So in your examination you will get a 10 marks problem on retirement of a partner, and let us see this. Okay, let us solve the full problem on retirement. So in this problem, what is given to you is there are three partners, Ashish, Suresh and Lokesh, sharing profits in the ratio of 5:3:2. This is the old profit sharing ratio. Then you are given balance sheet of Ashish, Suresh and Lokesh. On the balance sheet, you are given liabilities, capital accounts then reserves, and then creditors and outstanding expenses are given as liabilities. And asset side, we have land, buildings, and plant and machinery, furniture, stock, and debtors and cash in hand. So this is the way it is given to you, balance sheet. And then other information is also given. Let us see what is the information given. So who retires there? Suresh retires on which date? On 30th June. So that is in the middle of the year he retires. And some adjustments are given. Stock is valued at rupees 172,000. Then furniture and fittings valued at 80,000. Then we have a profit share of that is Suresh, because he retires in the middle of the year. So profit share of Suresh is we have to calculate based on the last year's profit. This adjustment also you have learned. Then you have learned goodwill treatment. So goodwill is also given here. So we have to adjust the goodwill of a retiring partner. And then what we have is finally the amount paid to a retiring partner. So it is partly paid in cash and part of the amount is transferred to his loan account. So this adjustments we have to make. And finally, the partners share the new profits in a certain ratio. So new profit sharing ratio is also given to you. Okay, so this is the problem given. Let us solve now this problem. So when you solve the problem, what you have to do first thing is you can simultaneously open revaluation account, partner's capital. That is what is asked here. So you read the last sentence. So in the last sentence, what is given to you? Prepare partner's capital accounts, prepare revaluation account, and also the balance sheet of the new firm. Okay, so simultaneously you can open all, but I will show you first how the ledger accounts are to be prepared, and then we will see the balance sheet. Okay, so what we will do is we will first open revaluation account, then we will open partners capital accounts. Okay, so now we have this is the way you have to do it. So don't spend more time in drawing the columns. So you have to do it as quickly as possible because entire problem we have to solve. And one by one, let us take all the adjustments. So what order to be followed when you solve this problem? The very first thing what you have to do is you have to record their capital balances. So whatever balance sheet values are there, no? So those should be adjusted first and then we will come to the other information. Okay, so what are the balance sheet values? The very first thing given to you is their capital balances. So these capital balances are given on the liability side. So it should appear on the credit side of partners' capital accounts. So how do we write the opening balances? These are the opening balances. So opening balances given to you is 7,20,000 Ashish, then 15,000 for Suresh. And it is 3,45,000 of Lokesh. Okay, so all this is what we have done. So let me show you. See here, whatever we have recorded, let me mark it so that we will be assured that we have not missed any of the item. Okay, so this balance is recorded. What is the next thing we have to record from the balance sheet is distribution of accumulated profits, right? So what is given here is reserve fund, right? This reserve fund should be distributed to all the partners, and reserve fund is a part of profit, so it will increase the capitals. So it is credited to partners' capital account in their old profit sharing ratio. So what is the old profit sharing ratio given? 5:3:2. So always don't forget this. This is the ratio given. So with this ratio, we distribute that 1,80,000 reserve fund. Okay, so where it will appear? On the credit side of partners. How do it will appear? By reserve fund, and their share is 90,000, 54,000 and 36,000 respectively. So you calculate on your calculators. How do you calculate it? 5 + 3 + 2, so total share is 10. So 5/10 is the share of Ashish, and 3/10 is the share of Suresh, and 2/10 is the share of Lokesh. And this is the way we distribute that 1,80,000. Then next is we will, I think these are the balance sheet values we have already recorded. So let us go for other information. Now in the other information, what is given? Suresh retires and following are the adjustments agreed upon. Okay, so what is the first thing what we have here is we have stock to be revalued, right? So stock is already given to you is how much? Stock is given to you is 1,85,000 here. Okay, and what is the new value of stock? 1,72,000. So what has happened to stock? Stock has decreased, right? So when it decreases, revaluation account should be debited. Why it is debited? Because there is a loss. So with loss, revaluation is debited, and with profit or gain, revaluation is to be credited. Okay? So students, where do we record it? On the debit side of revaluation account. Okay? So how it will appear? To stock. Okay? And what is the difference between the two values? 13,000. So this 13,000 is debited to revaluation account. Then next is what? Let us see the next. What is next given? Furniture, right? So what is the value of furniture given here? New value given to you is 80,000. And already furniture is how much here? There is a furniture of 77,000. Okay? So what has happened to furniture? Furniture has increased. So there is a gain and it will appear on the credit side of revaluation account. And how do we write it? Buy furniture. And what is the amount of difference? 3,000. Okay? So 3,000 is credited to revaluation account. Okay? So then what is the next thing what we have is profit share of Suresh. So that is a separate adjustment. So that we shall see later. Then next is there is an amount of 10,000 due from Deepak. So who is this Deepak? Deepak is a part of debtors. Okay, so what is the amount of debtors given to you in the balance sheet? It is given as 1,72,000. Okay, and out of this 10,000 are doubtful. Meaning what? Who are debtors? Debtors are the parties from whom business has to receive money. Okay, so what is the total amount receivable from debtors? 1,72,000. But out of this, 10,000 is doubtful, right? And this 10,000, which is doubtful, the firm makes a provision for the same out of profits. So this provision is according to the concept of conservatism, right? Last year you have learned it in 11th standard. It is also called as a concept of prudent. Okay, so it is a policy of playing safe. So any estimated losses in the future should be provided for, okay, out of profits. So this is what is done, and this provision is actually a deduction. It might reduce the debtors, and it is a additional provision which is created from the profits, and therefore here the treatment for provision is same like liabilities. Already when I explain you the revaluation account, I have shown you the liabilities and provisions we are debiting to revaluation account. Okay, when I showed you earlier the adjustments when we discussed. So provision has increased, right? Earlier there was no provision, and now the provision has increased. Total provision 10,000 increase. So it will appear on the debit side of revaluation account. So how do we record it? To provision for doubtful debts. So in short, you can write it as PDD. Or it is also called as PBD, that is provision for bad debts. Or it is also called as PBDD. So these are the various ways in which we write this provision. And here it is given provision for doubtful debts. So therefore we have taken here as PDD. And what is the amount of provision there? 10,000 is directly given. Sometimes it is given in percentage. So when it is given in percentage, you have to calculate the value on the debtors. Sometimes increase, decrease is given. You have to compare the previous values and the new values, and difference we have to either debit or credit according to whether provision has increased or decreased. So provision for doubtful debts is debited to revaluation account. Okay. Now we have seen the various items which are given as per the adjustments, and we have recorded them in the revaluation account. And there are no more items to be revalued or reassessed even for as far as liabilities are concerned. So we can now go for balancing of revaluation account. So balancing meaning what? You have to find out the total of revaluation account So which total is more there? Debit side total is more, right? So it is 23,000, right? So both the totals should be equalized. So we get 23,000 on the credit side also. And the difference is, whatever difference you get, that is, what is it? Actually, you have learned it in admission. When debit is more than credit in revaluation account, what do we get? Yes, very good. It is loss. Okay, so this loss has to be distributed between the partners in their old profit sharing ratio. So how much loss we get if we 23,000 is debited and credit is only 3,000. So difference of 20,000 we distribute in the ratio of 5:3:2 between the partners. So how do we write that? We transfer that loss to partners' capital account. Partners' capital accounts are to be debited and revaluation account credited. So how do we write it? By partners' capital accounts and transfer it to Ashish account, Suresh account and Lokesh. That is including retiring partner in the ratio of 5:3:2. So this is this 20,000 amount when we distribute. So how, what is the share of each partner? It is given to you 10,000, 6,000 and 4,000. Is that clear to you? And the same will appear. So simultaneously, this is a credit we have shown. Now simultaneously, it will appear in the partner's capital account. So for every debit, there is corresponding credit. So why do we debit partner's capital? Because capital account decreases. Okay, so how do we write it? To revaluation. In the bracket, you may write profit there and each share, respective share in there, write in their columns. So Ashish 10,000 loss, Suresh 6,000 and Lokesh 4,000. So this, with this revaluation account is closed, okay? And we find the revaluation account, which is loss debited to partners' capital accounts. Now let us take the next adjustment. What is it? Now what is given to you next is, so whatever we have done so far, we will tick mark so that we will know lot, like what are the adjustments we have done. So profit share, what is said about profit share? Suresh should get the profit till the date of retirement and calculated based on the previous profit of the firm, which is rupees, how much given here? 2 lakhs. All of you just have a look. So 2 lakhs is the profit given to you. And this 2 lakhs profit, how do we calculate? Now this is a 2 lakh profit of the previous year. Now based on the same, we will calculate, and you have already learned how to calculate the profit. I have taken the example. There are three options based on the previous year's profit, based on the average profit, or based on the sales. So the first option is used in this problem, okay? Based on previous year's profit given to you is 2 lakhs. So how do we calculate Suresh share there? That is retiring partner share in 2 lakhs, that is last year's profit, multiply it with proportionate period, multiply it with his share. So his share meaning profit share. So what is it? 2 lakhs, multiply it with proportionate period. Proportionate period meaning that intervening period till the date of retirement, that is from the date of last balance sheet till the date of retirement. So last balance sheet date is 31st March and he retires on 30th June. So how many months in between? 3 months. So 3 upon, out of 12, no? 12 months total. So 3 upon 12 is a proportion. Okay, suppose if he retires after 6 months, then you have to take proportion as 6 upon 12. So it depends, like what is, you have to be very careful, you have to see on which date he retires, and accordingly you have to take this proportionate period. Then multiply it with his share. What is his share? His share is already known, ratio is 5:3:2, and he retires and his share is 3 upon 10. So multiply it with 3 upon 10, and what is the answer you get here is 15,000. This 15,000 should be credited to retiring partner's capital account because his capital increases and he gets his share, okay, in the profit, okay, up to the date of retirement. So how do we record it? For the time being, already the journal entry we have discussed earlier, isn't it? Because this is not a true profit, this is not an actual profit, this is a share in the estimated profit based on the previous profit, okay? So since it is accrued or estimated for that particular period, therefore temporarily we transfer this profit share to profit and loss suspense account, okay, and till it is written off, it will be shown in the balance sheet. So when we prepare a balance sheet, we have to show the suspense account in the balance sheet. Okay, there is another way also. It can be written off by debiting the remaining partners capital accounts in their gaining ratio, but now we will not see that. We will transfer it to balance sheet, so we will show it in the balance sheet, profit and loss suspense account. So what is it? 15,000 we are crediting to Suresh, because Suresh capital account only increases. There is no adjustment in Ashish and Lokesh account. Okay, so this is about profit share. So we have done profit share. What is the next thing we have now? Goodwill, right? So what is goodwill given here? Goodwill of the whole goodwill of the firm. I mean, entire goodwill is given. How much is the goodwill at the time of retirement of a partner we have here? Goodwill value is given to you is rupees 2 lakhs. Okay, but this goodwill we don't have to adjust. We have to calculate his share, meaning Suresh share, and then we have to make the adjustment by debiting other partners, meaning remaining partners capital accounts in the gaining ratio, and crediting only the retiring partner. Okay, so his capital increases and other two partners' capital will decrease. So therefore, it is to be debited to them. So let us see now the calculations first, and then we will see the entry. Okay, so this is the calculation which is given here. So all of you just have a look. So 2000, what is his share is 3 upon 10. So what is the goodwill amount you get is 60,000. And then we distribute it in the gaining ratio. So gaining ratio is not given to you in the problem. So this is, students, you have to be very particular. Whenever goodwill is distributed, you have to find out the gaining ratio. If directly given, no need to calculate. But here, what are the particulars given? Old profit sharing ratio and new profit sharing ratio of partners is given. So old, we know 5:3:2. And the new profit sharing ratio here given to you is 3:2. And then accordingly, we have to, taking into consideration this old share and new share, we will calculate the gaining share. You know what is the formula there. Gaining share is equal to new share minus old share. So in Ashish's case, I will not discuss in details how we have calculated, because calculation part we have already discussed. Okay, so what is this share after calculations? 1 upon 10. And how much Lokesh? That is 2 upon 10. So what is the gaining ratio there? Denominators we have to make equal in case of fractional figures. So 1:2 is the ratio there. So same thing, this 60,000 which is given here, we distribute in the ratio of 1:2. So 1:2 is the gaining ratio. And what is the share? 1/3, who will get? Ashish. And who has to bear? Ashish. And 2/3, who has to bear? Lokesh. Okay, so this 20,000 and 40,000 is debited to remaining partners capital account, and entire 60,000 should be credited to retiring partners capital account. So this entry we have to show on both the sides. So let us see how it appear. So Ashish, by Ashish, capital in Suresh column we have 20,000, and by Lokesh capital, so that share is 40,000, and same will appear on the debit side also to Suresh capital. I had shown you when we solved the small examples we have seen earlier. So same treatment we are giving here, debited to Lokesh 40,000. So this is about goodwill. I think goodwill treatment is very much clear now. So we have seen goodwill. What is the next thing what we have to do is, we have to make the payment now to Suresh. So next adjustment is, Suresh was paid 40,000. So he is paid partly in cash, and remaining is transferred to his loan account. Okay, so let us make the payment to Suresh. How do it will appear? Suresh capital account debit to cash. Okay, so how much we have paying him? 40,000. So all of you look here, this cash is paid to Suresh. Okay, so that is over, and then balance we transfer to his loan account. How do we find out the balance? What is the first thing you have to do? So when you have to pay him balance, if balance is given to you directly, well and good. So you can, sometimes balance is given, what is cash paid to him, you have to find out. Now in this problem, cash paid is given, balance we have to find out. So to find out that balancing figure, first we have to make the total of credit side, and then same total you write on the debit side, and the difference should be transferred to his loan account. Okay, so what is the total here? Suresh account, we have 5,44,000. Same total you write in his debit side also, 5,44,000. And difference is how much you get, you transfer to his loan account. Because already part payment is made in cash, now this amount should be transferred to his loan. So what is the journal entry there? Suresh capital account debit to Suresh loan account. Capital decreases and loan account increases. Now for a firm, it is not a partner. He is not a partner, but he is outsider, where as if firm has taken loan from him and that loan has increased, and therefore it is to be actually shown, transferred to loan account, and it is shown in the balance sheet as a loan and not as a capital. Okay, so with this, I think, and the last thing remain is what we have to balance now other partners' capital accounts. So now let us see the balance sheet. Now balance sheet we are preparing on 1st July because on 30th June he retires. And when you prepare a balance sheet, has two sides, liabilities and assets. So liability side we shall start first, and capital accounts are given to you. We have found out actually the closing capital should be taken as the value of capitals, and this capitals are given here already. Closing capital 7,80,000 and 3,37,000 of Ashish and Lokesh, and the total of that will be recorded on the liability side of balance sheet in the outer column. Okay. Then after that, what is the next thing we have to do is, let us go to the balance sheet, and here we have sundry creditors, isn't it? So let us record the sundry creditors. There is no reassessment of this value, and therefore creditors remain same, so it will remain same, 1,24,000. Then one more liability we have also, outstanding expenses here. So that outstanding expenses will appear again in the new balance sheet. And it has remained same, no change, so it is 16,000. Okay, so we have outstanding expenses, and expenses we have to record as it is because there is no change in that. So 16,000. Then we have next is what? Now Suresh is no more a partner. Now he is a a creditor like. And his account amount is transferred to his loan account. So this loan account should be shown as a liability on the liability side of balance sheet, and it will appear here on the liability side as rupees 4,98,000. Okay. Now next, let us go for asset side. And asset side, what is first thing we have is land. So land value has not changed, so it has remained same. Then second, what we have is building. So building value has also not changed, it has remained same, so we have recorded it now. And plant and machinery value also is not changed, so no more revaluations, and 4,65,000, whatever figure given to you, it has remained same. Then next is furniture and fittings, right? Furniture and fittings, we have a value of 77,000, and there is already furniture here in revaluation account. It has increased by 3,000. So we have already done it in revaluation. So when you record the assets and liabilities, you have to see in the revaluation account whether there is any increase or decrease, and accordingly we have to consider. Okay, so furniture I'll record like this. Furniture, their book value 77,000, and 3,000 is increased value. So that is to be appreciation added, and net value is 80,000, which is recorded in the outer column. Okay, so the next thing what we have is a stock, isn't it? Stock value is also, there is a decrease in the stock of rupees 13,000. So how do we record the stock? Stock value given is 1,85,000, and less decrease is 13,000, and outer column you record 1,72,000. Okay, then next is about debtors, right? So debtors, how it is? 1,72,000 given, and there is a provision made. Now provision, we can record it on the liability side as an increase provision, total provision, or you may deduct it from. So actually the proper meaning, practices to record it on the asset side and shown as a deduction from the debtors. Okay, so how it will appear now? Sundry debtors less PDD. Why less? Because actually it is a provision. It is a figure of on the liability side also. We can record it, but instead when you are showing it on the asset side, we cannot show it as it is. We have to show it as a deduction from the debtors. So 1,72,000 and less PDD is 10,000, and outer column we record 1,62,000 as a net debtors. Okay, so debtors have decreased, right? So we are showing it. So that is the correct way of showing. Then we will go for the next, that is cash at bank. Okay, cash in hand, sorry. So if cash at bank is given, you record it as bank. If it is cash in hand is given, you record it as cash in the asset side. Now, when we record cash, we have to see if there are any changes in the cash. Of course, there is a change, isn't it? So whether cash has increased and decreased, we have to see. If there is increase, you have to add it. And if there is any decrease, you have to deduct it. So now there is a payment made to Suresh, 40,000, already we have seen. So cash will decrease, so it will be shown like this, cash in hand less paid to Suresh. So how much we have paid? 40,000. And what is the net cash recorded in the outer column? 81,000. Okay, so with this your balance sheet is complete. So cash in hand we have recorded as 81,000. Then there is you have to see the problem and see whether any more items are remaining. And we have here profit and loss suspense account of rupees 15,000, isn't it? So this 15,000, I told you that till it is written off, you show it in the balance sheet. So we are showing it in the balance sheet on the asset side, okay? Because it shows a suspense account shows a debit balance. So actually now there are more items to be adjusted in suspense account. Suppose if the partner retires, now in this problem only profit share was given. If there is any interest or any salary payable to a retiring partner, then that also is adjusted up to the date of retirement, and we adjust the same to profit and loss suspense account, and finally we balance the profit and loss suspense account. If suspense account shows a debit balance, it is on the asset side. If suspense account shows a credit balance, it is shown on the liability side of balance sheet. So now this details of suspense account, how suspense account is prepared and all, will be covered in the chapter death of a partner. Because you know, like retirement, usually it may not happen because retirement is at a convenient date, and death is a sudden. So when the partner dies, so whatever deceased partner's share up to the date of death, we have to adjust to suspense account. Okay, so you will learn it there. So at present, you remember that here profit and loss suspense account is debited, debit balance, and therefore it is shown on the asset side of balance sheet. That is rupees 15,000, and with this, your balance sheet is over, and we have got the total as given, 17,55,000 as the total. Okay, so I hope it is very clear to you. This is the way you solve the problem. So simultaneously, you can do balance sheet also, along with ledger accounts, but for your more understanding in a proper way, I feel that it is better to explain you here separately. So I took up ledger account separate and balance sheet separate, but when you record in the balance sheet, you should see that you do not miss any of the items. Okay, so that's all for this particular problem. Then next you will be learning is adjustment of partners' capital accounts. So whatever adjustments earlier covered, we have solved now full problem on that. Now only two adjustments are remaining, and let us see first how to adjust the partner's capital accounts. So what is it? Now see, when a partner is retiring, the retiring partner will go, but then remaining partners' capital balances we have seen in the earlier problem, isn't it? So it remained as closing balance, we kept it as same, and we showed the same in their new balance sheet. But most of the times they may decide that, or as per the agreement they may decide that they should change it. And this change may happen in a various ways. It depends on what is the situation. Okay, but this adjustment generally made in their new profit sharing ratio. So for this, you need to know the new. Now you will know like why you have learned new profit sharing ratio. because new profit sharing ratio is also required to adjust the capitals between the remaining partners when a partner retires. Okay, so after retirement, sometimes the remaining partners may agree to adjust their capitals in accordance with the new profit sharing ratio. So what is it? This required capital of the partners is known to you. What is is actually you have to calculate by taking into consideration their new profit sharing ratio. So we call it as a required capitals, or you can say the capitals which they need to have for the new firm. Okay, and how do we calculate it? By taking into consideration the new profit sharing ratio. Then what is the total capital? That we will see the situation, depending on the situation. Okay, so closing capitals are to be ascertained. Now in the previous problem we have seen how to write the closing. So those closing balances are the closing capitals or the existing capitals. Now existing capitals and these required capitals we have to compare, and if after comparing, suppose if their closing capitals are more than the required capital, then there is a surplus, meaning they have excess money in the business which they will withdraw, meaning the firm has to pay to the partner. Okay, and suppose if this existing capitals or those capital closing capital balances are less than required, then there is a deficit, and that deficit has to be brought in by the partner in the business, and this adjustment we have to make in cash. So cash or through bank account also, checks may be paid or checks may be received, or cash is paid or cash is received. So this is what, actually there is another way also, we can adjust it to partner's current account, but for your syllabus you have only the adjustments done through cash. Okay, so this deficit or surplus is adjusted in cash. Okay, so now what is a journal entry when there is excess or deficit to be adjusted? For excess or surplus capital, partner's capital account should be debited and cash or bank account is to be credited. Why capital account is debited? Because you see, payment is to be made, no, to the partner, and when we make the payment, now that means no more the amount is due to the partner, so is debited. And cash of bank account actually is credited because it decreases, because payment is made, it is paid off, the partner is paid off by the firm, so cash balance decreases, so asset decreases, credited. Okay, so when partner brings the amount into business, whatever deficit is there, when he brings, so cash balance will increase. Okay, and therefore we debit it, and partner's capital account is to be credited, because actually he is making the payment of cash. Okay, so this is these are the journal entries what we have. Now let us see the problems. So what is the first situation here? When a capital of the new firm is decided by the partners is specified. Now when your problem is given to you, what is the new capital, meaning the total new capital of the firm, either it is given or it may not be given. When it is given, you have to take the same and distribute in the new profit sharing ratio. When it is not given, we shall see the next. Okay, so when the capital of the new firm is given to you, so how do we do it? There is one illustration solved here. Okay, so who are the partners here? Mohit, Neeraj and Sohan are partners, and they are sharing in the ratio of 2:1:1. Neeraj retires and Mohit and Sohan decided that the capital of the new firm will be fixed at ₹1,20,000. So now you will notice that in this problem, this capital is given to you. Okay, when it is given, we have to distribute in the new profit sharing ratio to find out the required capitals of partners. Okay, and their existing balances, okay, already existing balances are given. So partners capital account show a balance of 82,000 here, and another partner's capital account, that is Sohan's capital account, shows balance of 41,000. Now what is this? These are the closing capitals after all adjustments, meaning we find out the total of credits, then total of debits. If debit is less than credit, we deduct the debit total, and then whatever the balances we get are the closing balances. So these are the capitals after adjustment. These are existing capitals of the partners. So now we know the existing capitals, we have to calculate the new capitals. So how it will be done in the solution? I have shown you it is adjusted only between Mohit and Sohan. So how have I shown? Here, new profit sharing ratio is 2:1, and the total capital of the new firm given to you is 1,20,000. So when you distribute in the ratio of 2:1, 2/3 and 1/3. So 2/3 is of Mohit and 1/3 is of Sohan. Okay, so what will be their balances when we calculate? 2/3 of 1,20,000, 80,000, and 1/3 is 40,000. And then existing capitals are already given. I have already marked 82,000 and 41. Now, students, you can easily identify here which capital is more. Yes, very good. Which capital is more? The existing capital is more for both the partners, that is Mohit and Sohan. So when existing capital is more, the partner has a surplus money. Now here they require only, see, Mohit requires only 80,000, but he has 82,000. So what is the difference? 2,000. So he is an excess amount, right? So which firm has to pay to the partner? And that means he will withdraw. Similarly, Sohan has 41,000, but he requires only 40,000. So that amount is actually shown as a surplus, and this surplus is to be adjusted in cash. So what entries we pass here? Mohit's account is debited, Sohan's account is debited to cash because it is amount is paid off. So when you prepare a balance sheet, in the balance sheet you have to show this adjustment in the cash account. When you record the cash balance, so it is shown as a deduction. Okay. So next we shall see is if when capital of the new firm is not specified, then what you have to do? So when capital is not specified, so all of you, this note is very important. So all of you, please go through it. The total capital of the new firm is based on the sum of the balance in the capital accounts of the continuing partners. What does it mean? Now you know the existing capitals, closing capitals, isn't it? So you have to find out what is the closing balance, total of the closing balance. And that should be the capital of the new firm. And that capital, that balance should be distributed in the new profit sharing ratio, and then you compare it with the existing balance and find out deficit or surplus. Okay, so how do we do this? So Asha, Deepa and Lata are partners. Their profit sharing ratio is 3:2:1. Okay, this is the old profit sharing ratio, sorry. And after making all adjustments relating to revaluation, goodwill and all those, their capital balances are given as rupees 1,60,000, meaning closing capitals are known to us, 1,80,000 respectively. Okay. Now here no new capital is given to you, meaning new firm's capital is not given. But we know the closing balance. Okay, when we know the closing balance, it is 1,60,000 and 80,000. So we have to add these two balances, and that is the total capital of the new firm. Okay, and then this should be distributed in the new profit sharing ratio. Now how it will appear, all of you just have a look here. Existing capitals are same, 1,60,000 and 1,80,000. Okay, then total capital of the firm will be how much now? 2,40,000. How do we get this? We are adding 1,60,000 and 1,80,000. Okay, so total of this is 2,40,000. This is the capital of the new firm. But now it will not remain same, 1,60,000 and 1,80,000, but it will be changing according to the new profit sharing ratio. That is, a new profit sharing ratio is it given to you? It is to be distributed in the new profit sharing ratio. Now who retires there? Deepa retires. Okay, so middle partner retires. So what is the closing capitals between the partner when this is the situation? The new profit sharing ratio is same as old ratio. Already you have learned, I don't have to explain you that. Okay, so in 3:1 we distribute 2,40,000, and what is the share of partners? So this is how we calculate: 3/4 of 2,40,000 and 1/4 of 2,40,000. So we get 1,80,000 and 60,000 respectively. Okay, so what you find here is, in Asha's case, Asha's new capital or required capital is 1,80,000 and existing capital is only 1,60,000. That means she is short of how much? 20,000. Okay, that she has to bring into the business. Okay, so the meaning there is a deficit. So deficit is brought in by Asha. And Lata's case, you will notice that her existing capital is more, 80,000, and her required capital is only rupees 60,000. So what we find is Asha has less capital, but Lata has more, isn't it? So what is the difference there? Again 20,000, but this is not deficit, this is surplus. She has more excess money and which she will withdraw. Okay, so this is how we show it. Cash to be brought in or withdrawn by continuing partners. So Asha will bring money of 20,000 and Lata will withdraw money of 20,000 because it is a surplus. So in Asha's case, what entry we will pass? Asha's capital has a deficit, so she will bring money. So cash or bank account is to be debited and Asha's capital account is to be credited. So in Lata's case, you will notice that she has excess money and therefore she will withdraw. So Lata's capital account is to be debited and cash or bank account is to be credited. And this cash or bank should be adjusted for the cash balance when we show it in the balance sheet. So Asha's balance will be actually added and Lata's balance will be deducted from cash balance and net cash we show it in the balance sheet. So this is how the capital adjustments are made.
Prudent Scholars, powered by Lupin Pharmaceuticals.